There are 10 million people in the U.S. and many more worldwide who are blind or facing blindness from diseases like macular degeneration and retinitis pigmentosa. Their best hope right now is through prosthetic devices. The problem is that current prosthetics don't work that well. Patients can see things like bright lights or high contrast edges, but nothing close to normal vision has been possible. I'm a computational neuroscientist, and I'm developing a new kind of prosthetic device for treating blindness. My focus is understanding the brain, how it works, how it solves problems. The brain is really just a giant math problem. People often ask, how did I crack the code that goes from the eye to the brain? And it's done as a combination of math and experiment. We presented images to the retina, and we recorded electrical pulses of the output cells. And then we worked out the mathematical relationship between the images and the output. In terms of developing this into a treatment for blindness, I had the code, but you know, how do you get the code sent up to the brain? So I was talking about it with a student, then all of a sudden I realized I have a complete treatment for making a prosthetic device to restore sight to the blind. I jumped out of my chair. It was a eureka moment, like, oh my God, I know what to do. Once I realized this, like, I couldn't eat, I couldn't sleep, all I wanted to do was work. So I, you know, madly laid out exactly how to do the experiment. We stayed half the night, and the first time we did it, it worked. We delivered the code, we took a completely blind retina that had no photoreceptors at all, and we made it fire just like a normal retina. It was actually totally thrilling. The way a normal eye works is when you're looking at something, it goes into your eye and it lands on your photoreceptors. The photoreceptors pass their signals through the retinal circuitry to the output cells, which send the information onto the brain. When it sends the information on, it sends it in this form of electrical pulses that are in a code, sort of like Morse code, that only the brain understands. So what happens when you get a retinal degenerative disease? What happens is your photoreceptors die, and over time, a lot of the rest of the retina dies too. But those output cells, they remain intact. What we've done is we've built a device that can take images in, so it has a camera, that acts like the photoreceptors, and then we have a little chip that will convert the images into this code, and then it will send the signals to the output cells, and then the output cells can send them onto the brain. This is what the retina would be seeing using the standard prosthetic. Here's what the image actually is. It's a baby's face, and here's how it looks through our prosthetic. Okay, so not only can you tell that it's a baby's face, but you can tell that it's this baby's face. Sometimes I'll just take long, long, long walks up and down Park Avenue and just be thinking. As exciting as it is to realize that you have the potential to make a treatment for something sort of big, like restoring sight to blind people, with it comes this massive responsibility. I get an email from somebody getting macular degeneration and they can't see their own children's faces. And so this inspires me. I know I can't screw this up. Once you hit it, you have to move madly forward. So it's doing the experiments, seeing if it works, writing it up, presenting it, then going out and raising the money to try to do it so we can set up to test patients, hopefully in a year and a half. That moment when you are with a blind person and they can say, oh my God, I can see your hand. I can see your face. I just saw you smile. I can't imagine anything else greater than that. So this is what we're striving for.